Assalamu alaikum, my dear student. Welcome to Asadullah Khan Junior College. Today we are going with the orientation lecture for related to information technology for 11th standard. What is information technology? With the help of the diagram, I will be able to explain you. Information technology is nothing but it related to the data, to the hardware, to the computer, to the security, to the design, to the application we use, to the client server, another thing, or the networks what we are. This is all related to information technology. In the next part, we will be knowing the definition of information technology. The definition what is of information technology is, it is used for storing, protecting, processing, securing, transmitting, receiving, and retrieving information. What does it mean? Means this information technology not only store your data, it also protects your data. Whatever information you that it also protects and process, means when you want to give it to other person or want to use it for yourself, then it process it. It secure the data. I mean, securing means it will it will be in a secure, means no one illegally can handle your any of the information, transmit your data. Receiving the information and retrieving the information means you can exchange mails or exchange idea with the help of information technology. Next, information technology helps you to understand the virtual technology. It means imagine. Virtual is nothing but what is virtual? It is an imaginary technology used in today's world. Oftenly you have seen many of the things. If you have seen it, that is you don't know about mobiles, but nowadays every small kid now is knowing that virtual technology like mobile, Android phones, or some of the neurons and many of the networking technology, digital marketing, they are knowing many of the new technologies. They are knowing virtual technologies. There are robotic technologies which are just imagining, and then they implement on this and by with the help of coding and other things. Next, it helps you to choose your career also. With the help of this technology, you can choose your any career in science field, in commerce field, in arts field, any of the field. You can choose your career very nicely with the help of IT. Function of IT. What is the function? First function is to capture data, to get retrieve the information of all the data which is in a raw form into a specific information in a formatting. Unorganized form means it will be randomly you are speaking and giving the data, but it is on a computer system, it is organized form with the help of certain particular details. Next, storage of data is there, which is used, we can use it for future. For example, you are writing a resume for yourself and just to apply, okay, in future. Then there you can go with the mail, you can save there also, you can go in Google Drive, wherever you want to store it, and whenever you want to retrieve the information and get the data. Transmission means you can contact, you can mail, you can do anything with the help of the IT. Processing, conversion of raw data into information, into specific information, that can be done with this processing. Data retrieval means whenever you want to retrieve. Retrieve is nothing, whenever you want that is information needed. It's simple nowadays, we want an Aadhaar card is linked in every field. And so information is needed, then you retrieve the data from the UID. Next is displaying of the data onto the people, information to the user whenever you want. When the user want any of the data, you can present it with the help of your Gmail or mailing or giving the text message onto the computer system. Many of the sources are available. Now this is the model of the, your data is there, where data you go is a raw form. Here it will be put again into the hardware, that is the into the hardware system. From the hardware system, it will be implemented to the software system. Then the software system will procedure will be done, and then the it is stored in it. Now vice versa, the stored data can be given to you in the form of information, or if you want that. So see, this is how the work it works. If you have seen, the arrow shows you that all the things is in this process is formula, such as that data directly go here and then the procedure is done, and then it collected to into information. What is the information system? An organized combination of people, hardware, software, communication, everything, whatever the related to. It will be related to people, it will be related to the hardware, like monitor, keyboard, mobiles, and these are hardware. And it will be related to software, like simple software, that is a Microsoft Office will be there, that is .NET is there, programming language are there, communication network, which type of communication, wireless network you are using, wire network you are using, that is also the data resources, which how the resources are going on and how the collect the data. This is all related to the information system. Data versus information. What is data? Data is nothing but an unorganized fact. It is an unorganized, raw organized. It's a simple way. I just want someone come for the investigation. I want the detail of your family. You just provided with verbal communications. Okay. But he will write down on the book or paper or anything. But this is a raw data. He will write down. Now, this data will be entered to your computer system with the help of certain software or hardware. And that is called as information. A collection of facts, it is unorganized, now it will be in an organized manner, and then that's consisted of, this is vice versa, data and information are vice versa. Computer software. What is computer software? Computer software is nothing but a collection of computer program related to data that instruct the computer what to do and what not to do. Means it will help you. Means operating system here. The computer or the mobile will not be working until or unless it will be having a system software with it. And for a mobile, most probably it is having Android operating system, and if you are having an Android mobile, and if you are having a simple mobile, there will be a certain system, operating system, which is Java will be there, Java platform will be there, which will be working on, or in your mobile computer system, or in your laptop, if you are having going, if you all knows about you, nowadays you everyone know about Windows are there, then your Linux are there, then your Unix are there. These are some of the operating system we are working with. And what is the application where you write or information, that is called where you enter it. Operating system deal with the hardware of your system, and application software deal with your software that is related to the data you enter. And it might be Microsoft Office, or if you want to make a website and other thing, there will be a .NET programming language. Other languages are there which is used to it. So hope you understand the computer software. Next is computer hardware. What is a computer hardware? Hardware in the computer is nothing but it refers to the physical, which you can test. This is where the software is a imaginary, where hardware is a things which you can, the physical component at which you can touch it up, and will be related to what of the hardware, your computer monitors, your laptops, your keyboard, your mouse. It is all which you can touch up. And it is in the form, it is divided in the form of three parts: input, output, and system unit. And input will be with the things which you enter into the computer with the help of that, that is your keyboard, mouse, and the scanner. Output will be that monitor, printer, which will be giving you the output, and system will be the hard disk and motherboard. Hope you understand it. Now, after this explaining, why I have given you the explanation, that you know when you enter to this IT section, you should know about these basic things. Now, according to your syllabus, theory part consists of four topics: basic of information technology, introduction to DBMS, impressive web designing, and the cyber law. Okay, this is a theory part of yours in your textbooks, related to your textbook. Practicals related to it is these are the practicals. These are almost three. Okay, daily computing, web designing, client side scripting, accounting, digital content, DBMS. For you, for the commerce section or for the science section, they are part are divided. Now you have for the daily computing libraries for the commerce section, web designing for the commerce section, accounting and package for the commerce section. Where? JavaScript for the common section, science section, web design also for the science section, and next this is your DBMS for the science section. So this is how the content is divided up. Reduced syllabus, whatever the reduced syllabus for 2020-21 is there, it will be in this form. On the first chapter 1.4 and 1.6, that is intro to GNU and Linux and network configuration. The page number is also given.
Next is introduction to DBMS, these two, 2.7, 2.9, and 2.10. Third, improvisive web designing, client-side scripting, and fourth, in cyber law, the IT Act of 2000. This is the reduced syllabus, that is the 25% of reduced syllabus in your book. For the SOP, there are reduced, the first daily company, daily company SOP 2 is not there. Digital has, it is not done for the science or commerce, this is not related, but DBMS SOP 1, SOP 2 and SOP 3 is not been done. So it is a non-evaluative part of it. Some of the application where you use right now day to day, that is in your business you are using, in your industry you are using, in the product design, product manufacturing. At home we are also using technology. Nowadays we are using in education, many of you now online we are studying, okay, and sometimes it's technology like science and engineering. So hope you understand the all the part of it. There I have come gone with your orientation lecture, I have gone what is the information technology, then I have shown you the theory, whatever the content you have to study, and what things are reduced in 2020-21. So hope you understand it. Thank you for watching my video. Jazakallah khair. Please subscribe my channel.